In this video, you'll learn how wages are determined in perfectly competitive markets. After that, we'll look at how changes in supply and demand impact equilibrium. In the videos preceding this one, you've learned about how the supply and demand for a perfectly competitive labor market are determined. Now we'll bring it all together to see how wages are determined. This is very similar to the supply and demand graph you learned in AS, but it corresponds to the market for labor. Very simply, the equilibrium wage rate and equilibrium quantity exist where the supply of labor equals the demand for labor. This graph has been drawn exactly how you should be drawing it in your notes and as well as your exams. Set up your axes as such, then draw in a downward sloping demand curve and label it DL. Next, add in your supply curve and label it SL. Then we draw a dotted line to the y-axis and call this wage rate W star. Similarly, we drop down to the x-axis and label that point Q star. W star is the equilibrium wage rate, and Q star represents the equilibrium quantity of labor. Just like we did in AS for product markets, we are now going to analyze changes in supply and demand in perfectly competitive labor markets. Pay particular attention to how the diagrams are drawn and how the changes are described. Being able to replicate how I do it will help you integrate diagrams more effectively into your responses. I've listed the demand shifters I covered in an earlier video here. If you want to go back and review them again, find the video and then come back to watch the rest of this one. So the factors that might cause a demand for labor to shift include a change in the demand for the good or service that labor is producing, a change in the price of the good or service that labor is producing, a change in the cost of capital relative to labor, government regulation and subsidies, and finally, labor productivity. So suppose there is an increase in the demand for the final good that labor is producing. This would cause an increase in the demand for labor, shifting the demand for labor from DL to DL1. I draw this in with an arrow and also add in the increase in the wage rate from W star to W1. The equilibrium quantity of labor employed in this market has risen from Q star to Q1. Similarly, if the marginal revenue product falls due to a fall in the price of the product, then the demand for labor across the industry would fall, shifting the demand for labor from DL to DL1. This would cause the equilibrium wage rate to fall from W star to W1, and equilibrium quantity of labor to fall from Q star to Q1. Similarly, for supply shifters, go back and review the earlier video to understand why exactly these factors would cause labor supply to shift. For now, I'll list them out and refer to some as examples in the diagram that follows. The supply shifters include changes in demographics, changes in the retirement age, net migration, taxation and benefits, preferences towards leisure time, changes in non-pecuniary benefits, barriers to entry, trade unions, and alternative opportunities for labor. Suppose this diagram represents the market for factory workers. If there is large-scale migration of unskilled workers to a country, then this would increase the supply of labor across many industries, particularly manufacturing. This would lead to an increase in the supply of labor from SL to SL1 and cause the equilibrium wage rate to fall from W star to W1 and equilibrium quantity of labor to rise from Q star to Q1. Suppose the wages in manufacturing rise, causing domestic workers to leave their jobs for work in factories. This would reduce the supply of domestic workers from SL to SL1 and result in an increase in the wage rate from W star to W1, as well as a reduction in the quantity of labor from Q star to Q1. Now that you've seen the changes in the diagrams, try to complete the table here. In each situation, you need to determine whether supply or demand will change, how it will change, and what impact that will have on the equilibrium wage rate and quantity of labor. Give it a shot, pause this video, and I'll share the answers next. In the first situation, where the power of unions has been weakened, the amount of workers who can enter the profession will increase. This increases the supply of labor and causes the equilibrium wage rate to fall and the equilibrium quantity of labor to rise. Second, if society becomes more aware of these negative externalities, then it's likely their demand for coal will fall and thus the demand for workers in the industry will fall. This will cause the equilibrium wage rate and equilibrium quantity of labor both to fall. Third, workers will find it more attractive to work in clean energy production and leave their jobs in coal mining to work in clean energy production for higher wages and better conditions. This will cause the supply of labor in coal mining to fall, causing the equilibrium wage rate to rise and equilibrium quantity of labor to fall. Fourth, new technology will increase worker productivity and across the industry increase marginal revenue product. This would increase the demand for labor and cause the equilibrium wage rate and equilibrium quantity of labor to rise. If the legal working age is dropped from 18 to 17, then the supply of labor will increase, causing the equilibrium wage rate to fall as more workers compete for jobs and also increase the quantity of labor. Hopefully you've gotten all the answers right to the practice questions, but if you haven't or you didn't, leave a comment below and let's try and figure it out together. Also, do the same if you're stuck on anything at all that was covered in this video. That's us done for now, and I'll see you in the next one.